Now, the coronavirus continues to challenge public health at every level. That's according to the director of Pan American Health Organization, PAHO, Dr. Carissa Etienne, who was addressing the latest COVID-19 press briefing in Washington, D.C. Tuesday morning. Dr. Etienne says this is a challenge that could eventually lead to a major public health issue for Latin America and the Caribbean region. Shamela Pullen reports.
Director of the Pan American Health Organization, PAHO, Dr. Carissa Etienne, says regular vaccination in Latin America and Caribbean countries restarted recently after it was impacted by COVID-19. But Dr. Etienne says many of these countries have been reporting difficulties accessing supplies.
The region has observed almost 60% decrease in reported cases of malaria. Now, this reduction does not mean that malaria suddenly is disappearing from the region, but rather it reflects that less people are seeking care due to lockdown or the inability to access effective care. With tuberculosis, for instance, countries have reported reducing frequency of outpatient visits to health facilities for treatment, for monitoring, and for even the collection of drugs.
The impact on mental health has also been significant, with increases in anxiety, depression, and sleep problems. Dr. Etienne says part of the challenge is that many health staff working in these areas have been assigned to deal with COVID-19.
The continuity of essential services provided at the first level of care has been especially affected in peri-urban and rural areas and among indigenous populations. This relates to the already existing deficit of health workers, along with social distancing measures, infected healthcare workers, and the closure of various primary care facilities in these areas.
PAHO says there is a need for health services to become more resilient, adding that health authorities should rethink how to effectively provide the services while dealing with the COVID-19 pandemic.
In order to be able to cope with an influx of patients regarding isolation capacities and also quarantine capacities, and an influx of severe patients in health services.
This pandemic, I'm afraid, is going to be with us for some time, and we cannot afford to place in jeopardy the health gains that we have made in this region. So with countries of the region, PAHO is working to find innovative ways to deliver effective, safe services to all the people.
Shamela Pullen, TVJ News.
In the meantime, Dr. Tufton gave an update on the dengue virus affecting Jamaica.
I am happy to announce, Mr. Speaker, that based on the most recent data coming out of the National Epidemiology Unit, the dengue outbreak, Mr. Speaker, is now officially over, Mr. Speaker. It means that we are no longer having cases of dengue above the threshold case. In fact, the last 4 months, we have seen below threshold numbers. 37 cases in March, 2 cases in April, 8 cases in May, and 2 cases in June. Mr.